Welcome everyone, Team 7 on another adventure, and today we're headed to Halloween Horror Nights 30. 30?
30.
That's what the shirt says, 30. As you can see, we're not at home. We're staying at Aventura? I don't know. Whatever you want to call it, Aventura, Aventura, whatever. But anyway, yeah, so it's what, September 18th today?
Yes.
So yeah, a little early, but we're also doing this. We're doing
Hollow Scream
to SeaWorld, right?
Yes, sir.
Are we doing the one in Busch Gardens?
There's not SeaWorld. One in Busch Gardens.
No, it's only SeaWorld?
I think it's only SeaWorld.
Okay, so we're going to Hollow Scream.
Hollow Scream.
Hollow Scream to SeaWorld later on, so we'll be recording that also. And yeah, if you want to see a little thing of the room, I'm pretty sure it was up already. Usually the room tours come first, right?
Yeah,
usually the room tours are first because they're unedited and it's just Kayla over there and her silly self just going through the room. So those are pretty easy to put out. So that'll probably be out first, and then this will follow. Who knows? Maybe I might feel a little bit ambitious and do both of them in the same thing. It's a hobby. I don't get paid to do this. I'm just doing this for fun. Just so when I can't do this no more, I can look back and say, yo, remember when we did this? Remember when we did that? Remember when we went here? Remember when we went there? Oh, look at this. Look at that. So, and then long after I'm gone, everybody can see my ugly face on YouTube.
It's going to be awesome.
I apologize for those of you in the year 2503. Anyway, what I was going to say something?
Maybe.
I was thinking I was going to say something. Anyway, join us. On our way. Also, too, I don't know if I mentioned this, but we're doing the RIP tour. It's raining right now. We're doing the RIP tour, so yeah. We'll find out what this is all about. Ready, Marvin?
You look ready.
I've
been ready for years.
Have you been?
At least 2 years.
At least two, right?
Let the games begin.
Where we're headed to, he said. Where we're headed to? Oh, look at this one. Scared already?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. Hey, look, want some bacon? He's making bacon.
Oh my God, Electra.
As you can tell, Kayla stayed home. She's not having it. But, Cafe La Mama there? Hey. Gotta go that way. This way, babe. Nancy, this way.
6 or 6:30. 6:30.
Oh my God. They're such wimps.
You did it.
She didn't do it yet. You ain't do it yet.
Meanwhile.
So at this point in the video, you might be wondering, oh my gosh, where's Kayla? Do not fret. I am right here in a hotel room chilling. And now you might be wondering, oh my gosh, why is Kayla in a hotel room and not at Halloween Horror Nights? Well, guess what? I also have that answer for you. And to put it simply, it's because Halloween Horror Nights is the ultimate package of everything I don't like. Being scared. Gore. Is there really anything else to put in that package? Maybe. But the point is, I really don't like being scared. It's a horrible feeling, honestly. For me, at least. I feel like I understand why a lot of people enjoy it. But for me, it just kind of gives me nightmares. And I'd rather avoid those at all costs, you know?
Right here once again, excellent guy. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and talk about this next scare zone again, or this next scare zone, what we're gonna do. This one right here is called 30 Years, 30 Fears. Another one of those like celebration scare zones we have this year. We're gonna find a lot of that in Halloween Horror Nights this year. This one is kind of like a portal and much less of like a scare zone itself. You're still gonna see a lot of characters. Well, yeah, you're still gonna see plenty of characters out there tonight. Sometimes the rain does affect a lot of our scare actors. We can't come out, especially on stilts and such. But we're gonna go through here. Normally when it's not raining, you're gonna see a pyro flashing on top of this frame right here. That sign right there is actually a throwback to a lot of the older HHN Halloween Horror Nights. The sign we use is there. So this once again is a really fun, it's like one of those celebration scare zones of the past 30 years. So we're trying to circle back with Scott Feeney before we have more scare actors out later on this evening. But when we do get there, kind of gives an idea what we have coming. Guys, we've got the 30 Years, 30 Fears, and then we're going to hit our first couple of haunted houses, all right? All right, guys. Shorter tonight. He's called Bones. He's from HHN 27. Everybody kind of remember. remembers that event from a few years ago.
I remember when I was 28. Terrain, and we're headed into our first two houses. What, Bride of Frankenstein and then Universal Monsters, right? Of course, no flash photography, so yeah. Cool part is they give you the whole backstory to the houses. I think that's the best part of this whole tour.
Alright, guys, follow me right this way. Thank you so much.
I don't know, like, if there was, like, a cut in between the first video. But now I have sushi. Yay. And it didn't really take that long. I literally just, like, walked downstairs, grabbed the sushi out of the cooler, and was, like, just paid for it. And that was it. The longest wait was, like, for the elevator backup because, like, there's a lot of people coming into the hotel right now. But yeah, I'm really just gonna eat. They gave me two things of chopsticks. I'm not even mad about it though, because I can just take one home and use it for like other food.
I really wish I could record inside the house, especially this one. This is gonna be the Halloween Horror Nights 30, like tribute house, where they have all the icons from all the past Halloween Horror Nights battling out to see who is the greatest icon, who reigns supreme. So I have a feeling it's gonna be Jack. Jack, of course, is my number one.
Jack.
So, yeah, I'm a Jack fanboy. You didn't know already. The mask you've been watching, you've been seeing me wear for over a year now. So. But other than that, money well spent. Money well spent was like, what, like 356 each?
Bargain.
Yeah, $352 each. So we spent over $1,000 to be here today and do all this stuff. But it was well worth it. I don't think I'm ever going to go back to the other way. I don't think ever. Ever?
What do you think?
See, if she says yeah, then it's going to happen. So only if we can get her to say yeah for that boat now. And what about that boat now, since you're so saying yeah for everything?
We're gonna get a picture of Jack.
Oh, it's definitely gonna happen.
After this 2-second debate I had with myself in my head, I decided that I was gonna do homework, but I was gonna do like the less homeworky homework thing I had to do, which is watch Inside, the Bo Burnham movie on Netflix. I have to watch it for like, cause I might be able to use it for like a project. So I like have to watch it. So it's like a homework assignment, and I have to eventually write this essay on it, which is so lame. But I don't really have to put a whole ton of thought into it like I would if like writing a research paper or like doing research in general. So it's kind of like the best of both worlds. Like, I'm getting work done technically, but I'm not having to put any thought into it and not having to be frustrated from doing work.
We're going back around again. How many houses in this one section?
We got a house.
Huh?
We're going to a bar.
Oh, going to the bar now?
Yeah.
Oh, so they're even taking us to the bar on the tour.
Hey,
what do you know?
I tell you,
the
bar.
That's it.
I got a part.
Money well spent.
Good choice.
I know. Chris is getting a lot more interesting as we go on.
All right, guys, since we're here, I was going to a bar after this, and I will. I'm just going to see if that one opens up. But in the meantime, I'm going to do the bathroom break right over here, guys. Stop right here. Have a few minutes. After we do the bathroom, we're going to grab that chair over there. And then we're going to go hit one of the bars we have, all right? If it's not this one, it's going to be a little shorter distance, all right? All right, cool, guys. If you will, wait right here if you don't want to go in.
Thumbs up for Chris.
We had to earlier. I'll be right back, okay? All right, guys.
I thought I had a lot of energy. Chris has some energy, boy. In fact, he's gonna be the new content creator and editor for Team 7 Adventure Bar.
I'm about ready to give him the camera.
I'm about ready to give him the camera and give him the whole damn channel. I'm ready to give him the whole damn thing. Maybe I'll subscribe for him. He obviously don't like me.
Alright, guys. So our next scare zone is called Seek and Destroy. Seek and Destroy is one of our original scare zones this year. Look at this, already freaking out on me. Alright guys, Seek and Destroy follows an alien cyber regime that has come to Earth that can take control and use our bodies for fuel to build their empire. So what they do, they are led by a character called the Controller. You can actually hear the Controller right now. He's their leader. The Controller is actually Halloween Horror Nights' first ever digitally created character. And you'll see him as we walk by. He'll actually talk to us, he'll interact with us, as he tries to actively recruit people into the regime and turn them into fuel. What you'll see in here is everybody dressed in these white uniforms, because he's got them, he's captured them, forced them to conform, and everybody else he's chasing. You'll see spotlights, you'll hear helicopters, you'll hear all these sounds as the regime is trying to chase us, the last people that are free on Earth to use us for fuel. Alright guys, we're going to go through, watch out, try not to get caught by the Controller, alright?
It's almost like the Matrix out here. It's just like the Matrix, right?
Like the Matrix.
Yeah, exactly. Hey, you know what? Hey, my fat ass will be a lot of fuel, boy.
Mine too, brother. You can take me to many places.
Oh, yeah. One job. I didn't even know he was standing there. I wish I would have known he was standing over my shoulder.
One almost got him.
that's where you'll find me.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, me too. Me too. Finnegan.
Take a picture of Finnegan's for the recap. How do you get that? Make him feel bad.
I saw that. I don't know. Listen, I don't know if I caught that or not, but I'm gonna check it in editing. I saw that. Nancy. Excuse me. Do you have any gray poupon?
No.
Checking your fever. Making sure you don't have the COVID.
Okay.
like her smile. Oh, excuse me. Definitely a pinch point, huh?
Yes, it is. Bottom it.
That was definitely a pinch point, huh?
Oh no, absolutely.
Oh, let's see.
I don't know, I just saw the cappuccino. I still see it. I see the light, yeah. Honestly, I'll give you one of those for next floor, just in case this goes out again.
I didn't need to.
No, I was saying earlier, it's time after the tour.
I'm still here. So, now it is approximately 10:40. I say approximately, but it literally is 10:40. I've been writing my essay for a while. Not really that long, but just been chilling writing my essay. And as I was writing it, I was like, man, I want some gelato, because I knew on the tablet over there, you could order gelato and like get it sent to your room. So I was like, I'm just gonna get gelato. It was like $6 for like regular size. And I was like, I'm gonna get chocolate. So I ordered the gelato and it was like, it'll be there shortly. I think I waited like maybe 20 minutes. It was like 20 or 30 minutes, I don't even know. But I waited that long. And guy knocks on the door and it's like, basically, here's your gelato. And gives me this container. And I was like, thank you. Have a good night. You know, like you do when you talk, not when you talk, but like when like you receive your food or like something you order. Well, I opened this. Look at how much gelato is in here. Look, I'm like, look how, just. $6. This was $6. This is a scoop, one scoop of ice cream. Like, I open this and I was just distraught. I'm still distraught, as you can see. I paid, I guess I technically didn't pay for it, but like, this is $6. And the worst part is I didn't get a spoon with this. And I only have chopsticks. So I guess I'm gonna have to eat this with chopsticks, because how else am I gonna eat it? And like, actually no, the worst part isn't that they didn't give me a spoon. The worst part is that this is one scoop of gelato. And it was $6. And I waited 30 minutes for it. And this is one scoop. I honestly think this might be the worst thing that ever happened to me. Maybe not, but I guess we're just gonna try this out now, because this is so sad. Like, this is a joke, I swear. Like, am I on a prank show? Like, I know I'm not, but like, this is too much. I can't. See, it's actually good tasting. But this is what I got. This is so sad. No, like, how am I supposed to like eat this? This is too much to like. I can't believe this is happening to me.
Thank you. Thank you for joining us. Now, get out.